Father, and to yours I am. accept the fragrance of this incense that we have offered to you on the feast of your ascension into heaven. Grant that we may prepare ourselves to receive the Holy Spirit, whom you promise to send to us. May we take the places that you have prepared for us in the presence of the Father, and meet you in the heavenly kingdom. We praise you, and your Father, and your living Holy Spirit, forever.
Seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. And he's put all things under his feet, and has made him the head over all things for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all.
Praise be to God always. Of the gospel of our Savior announcing life for our souls, we offer this incense and ask for your mercy, O Lord.
Peace be with you. From the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. John, who proclaimed life to the world, let us listen to the proclamation of life and salvation for our souls.
Remain silent, O listeners, for the Holy Gospel is about to be proclaimed to you. Listen and give glory and thanks to the Word of the living God.
When he had gone out, Jesus said, "Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I'm going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another, just as I have loved you. You also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." This is the truth. Peace be with you.
That almost for everyone,
how they understand love and how they understand unconditional love is the relationship with the child and their mother. You know, in some cultures you can just about make fun of and attack and say all kinds of odd things, but don't say anything bad about the person's mother. And I think all cultures have a reflective of that type of thinking and teaching. But we do learn about unconditional love from our mother, mostly. Not always. Sometimes it's the person who is the caregiver. Sometimes it is the father. But still, it's that child learning how to enter into an adult world by integrating, internalizing what they experience as a child. The baby that's never held does not eat and does not live. We are intrinsically in need of being nurtured. We are intrinsically in need of a type of love that we feel secure in order to be emotionally healthy and physically healthy. And so this role is very, very significant and very powerful. And even to be a good following Christian, we have to have some of that instinct or commitment within ourselves, whether it's our own child or not, whether we're male or female. If we are incapable of feeling nurtured, we're usually very incapable of nurturing those around us. Then much of the abuse that goes on in the world is from somebody who was abused as a child. Not always, but pretty close to it. If we only heard Jesus speak only a few times and didn't know the fullness of his stories and his parables and his teachings and their tradition, I'd be kind of shocked by this gospel, because he said, "You can't follow me. I've been walking with you for 3 years or so. You've seen me work miracles. People have found forgiveness. I've saved people's lives by stopping them from being stoned. I brought someone back to life that's been in the grave for 4 days. But now I'm going to leave you. And not only that, you can't come with me." But luckily for us, we know far more of the gospel and far more of the stories and how to approach this and how to believe in it. But this is necessary because he has to capture our emotions and our feelings as well as the reality. And I think the hardest and difficult thing about being a parent is when the child begins to show signs of wanting to be independent. And how very difficult it is for any parent, especially a mother, that when are they being loving or when are they being controlling and crippling their child? When is the time to challenge them and not to challenge them? And I think the more wealthier a society becomes, the more difficult it is. For my parents, if we wanted something, they could say they just can't afford it. But in today's world, it's tougher because we can probably afford it, but is it the right thing to get them at this time? You know, if they pester us long enough, will they give in? I remember my brother Kevin insisted that he, oh, I wasn't supposed to give his name, I'm sorry. His name is Alfred, no, not Billy. He did not want to buy a raffle ticket from the church whatsoever. He argued about it, and Finally, my dad convinced him that he really needed to do that. You know, he had a job, he has to take responsibilities, he was going to be an adult soon. It was time for him to begin to make decisions and be supportive. And he said, well, if I win, can I buy a mini bike? Who would have guessed he would have won, but he did. So next year, it wasn't hard to sell him a mini bike at all. A raffle ticket. But in this case, it was probably innocent, but on the other hand, we can dangerously begin to use God in different things, only for ourselves, and only for our own satisfaction, and forget about being able to empathize and feel along with those people who are hurting, along with those people who are living their life maybe differently. That Christianity is not just seeing what we can get out of it. It's not a drug. It's not meant to be something to deaden our senses in a form of escape, even though it certainly is used that way at different times. But by him giving this commandment to love, it is a huge challenge. And sometimes we mistakenly think that what this means is that we won't get in trouble if we do something wrong. Well, when we do something wrong, the best thing in the whole world is to get in trouble. Because sin and wrongdoing is trouble. It takes from somebody that we don't have a right to take, or it diminishes our own worth. You know, we certainly live in a society that as much as we have, we still are struggling with heroin addiction, all kinds of addiction. Because we have this innate desire or need to satisfy us fuller than what we already are. That we do have an emptiness within us. And part of that emptiness, growing up as a child, is satisfied in some ways by a loving parent, but that's not a guarantee. As we interpret life, even within our family, we do sometimes draw the wrong conclusion. You know, the painful day for a mother is the day that their child says, I hate you. I think most children have done something similar to that and brought their parents to tears. But love, a healthy love, challenges but doesn't reject. Disciplines but doesn't shame and embarrass. A healthy love certainly needs to know the appropriate boundaries. And that's true for everything. In marriages, as much as a couple may love each other, there are things that they can do to each other that can destroy it. There are things between parents and children that can be actions that can destroy the relationship. This teaching of Jesus is to make sure we understand all the different types of boundaries that are necessary so that we're not enabling the other person to remain perpetually nothing but a grown-up child, still dependent, still throwing temper tantrums, still not being able to carry the burdens and some of the joys of being an adult. And I know that line is very ambiguous sometimes, and it's hard to discern where that point is. And that's why we need continuously and constantly to learn more and more about following Jesus Christ. I find it quite remarkable in today's prayers. Help me want to follow you. Those aren't the exact words, but that's what it's saying. Sometimes we don't want to do the right thing. Sometimes we don't want to follow. Sometimes we universalize one wrong and everything's wrong. We all have that trait in some manner or another, but as we meditate and reflect, as we pray, and even as growing up when we are asked to do things that we don't want to do, but we do it out of love, care, and concern, It helps us become healthier to understand these boundaries, to be more trusting when it seems like the opposite would happen. The Lord Jesus is given to his apostles. You can't come yet because I have asked you to do something, something for me. I want you to go throughout the world and spread this message, teaching them all things, baptizing them, instructing them, showing what actual, true, genuine, mature love actually is. Sometimes it's very difficult. Sometimes it's very easy. Each child has its own personality. A parent cannot relate to each child identically because they're not saying and doing the identical same things as the other. Unless one of them is copying the other, then they both get in trouble. But I think you know what I mean. Love has its boundaries. There are times when we must say no, and there are times when we say yes. There are times when we must give, and there are times when we don't give. Love has its challenges. And there's no way I can make a list of what they all are. I think everyone here could make their own personal list. But within all of those things, there is pain, and there is joy. There is disappointment, and there is hope. There are misunderstandings and clarifications. There are doubts and there are strengths. There is faith and there is struggles. We are human and sometimes we feel like we are in a mess. But I know this one thing. The way to get out of it isn't through hatred, isn't through resentment, it isn't running scared, it isn't giving up, it isn't rejection, it is taking the wounds of life and combining them with the wounds of Christ. And we will be lifted up.
Substantial with the Father. Through him all things were.
accept the offerings of our ancestors. Now accept these offerings that your children brought to you out of the love for you and your holy name. Shower your spiritual blessings upon them, and in place of their earthly gift, grant them life in your kingdom.
Amen.
As we remember our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ and his plan of salvation for us, we recall upon his offering all those who please God from heaven to this day, especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, Saint Mary, Saint Joseph, and Saint Jude. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers, and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those for whom this sacrifice is offered. For our mothers, those who have passed on into glory, and those who are still with us. Remember also those who share with us today in this offering.
Amen.
Peace to you all, servants. brothers and sisters forever.
And with your spirit.
Let us lift up our thoughts, our minds, and our hearts.
We lift them all to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord with reverence and worship him with humility.
It is right and just.
Truly it is right and just to glorify and praise you, O God the Father, for you are holy and the giver of life. You are blessed with the only begotten Son and your living Holy Spirit. You are surrounded by the cherubim and seraphim, who sing with pure voices and heavenly melodies. They cry out and glorify and proclaim holy.
Heal us, O Lord.
strengthening of consciences, so that none of your faithful may perish. Rather, make us worthy to live by your Spirit and lead a pure life, and we raise glory to you now and forever.
Yourself. compassionate Lord, may we, your lowly servants, be made worthy to pray with purity and holiness, and to call upon you, saying,
Our Father, who art in heaven,
and for a new life.
suffering, O Lover of all people, have mercy on us.
Have mercy on us, O Lord, O compassionate and merciful One. O Lover of all people, have mercy on us.
Pearly, do you have the vocation icon this week?
Last week.
Oh, well, I just thought I saw it in the bulletin. I don't know. Well, here, I'll give this one out too. I might have remembered without needing to. Growing up, my brother, we were wondering what in the world did my each other down there. I mean, it was years before I realized that he was talking about us. You know, the song reminded me of that, of the worries of a mother. And I'm certain that we gave our parents enough to worry about. You'll also find in the entrances our financial report, if you're so inclined, you can pick one up and take it home with you. And I hope you have a wonderful Mother's Day. May everything that anybody picks for their mother turn out exactly perfectly. The right color when it comes out of the oven, whatever it is, that tastes delicious and good. We thank you, Lord God and Father, and ask that this divine communion be for the forgiveness of sins, the glory of your holy name, that of your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Peace be with you. Lord Jesus, our God and Savior, you became flesh for our sake, and by sacrificing yourself, you saved us. Deliver us from damnation and make us temples of your holy name, for we are your people and your inheritance. We glorify and honor you and your Father and your Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Go in peace, my beloved brothers and sisters, with the nourishment and blessing you have received from the forgiving of the Lord. May the blessing of the Most High Trinity accompany you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God to whom be glory forever. Amen.